give Minnie a number something.
Bye-bye.
Bye. Okay.
Little mini ones.
Here we are. Little mini ones. Here we are again at Oswego.
Woohoo.
Once again for the fifth time. Damn. My brain is off again.
Is that General Mao?
Is he in the background? Is that a guest appearance from Chairman Mao?
From Malcolm.
What level is that fan on? Is that the lowest level?
Yeah.
All right. Turn it off, please. I can hear it.
Noah.
No, turn the fan off. You're going the wrong way.
Wait, you can hear it over here.
Turn the fan off.
No, I can't, actually. We're good.
Okay. Never mind.
You can go anywhere in the room, theoretically. The cable's 10 feet long, and I have it almost in the center of the room. Okay. I just have the short one. Yeah, you could do it over there. All right, cool.
Yeah.
No. We got some...
No,
welcome to a Mischief Mini with an audience, I guess.
Yeah. First
audience. We got Erin back for the second time. Noah back for the, 17th time, I think. Something like that. Something stupid like that.
We're always stupid. We're always
and we're doing shit. We're doing biggest problem of the week. We're doing biggest problem of the week. All right. I have a big problem this week.
What's your big problem this week?
Yeah, you do.
My biggest problem is named Aleksey.
I was just about to name that. I'm not going to lie.
So we came out here. It's the sequel to the Halloween party.
Round two
of Halloween again. Second verse, same as the first. And, we had another party. Or I guess we went out on the town last night.
Yeah.
And we got an Airbnb. It's me, Malcolm, Aleksey. And things were fine for the most part. And then I guess at some point they weren't. And we got back to our room at 3 in the morning, something like that. Aleksey, we lost him for half an hour. He was already there. He's already in the room. And then he decides... He drove us out here, by the way, and he decides, I'm just going to go home at 3 in the morning drunk, and I'm not feeling the rest of the weekend.
Middle of the night.
Fuck you guys, I guess.
Middle of
the
fucking night.
Yeah, middle of the night.
Or middle of the morning. 3 in the morning.
Yeah,
morning.
It's about to be sun up. So me and Malcolm had to walk 2 miles from our Airbnb, which changed the locks on us, changed our code, onto this beautiful campus, uphill. Both ways. Uphill against the wind. That God really did not want us to make it here. And, luckily, you're going home instead of going to school here, Noah, so we're good, but...
Yeah.
Holy
we're
shit.
We're like refugees.
Yeah,
like
dude.
I said, it was like a pilgrimage.
What are you doing?
This is a sponsored ad from Graphite by,
Bath
& Body Works.
This episode is brought to you by Graphite by Bath & Body Works. Go online and use code Graphite for Graphite percent off Graphite.
Graphite percentage.
That's my biggest problem of the week. Because why the fuck would you do that?
I don't know why he'd want to come all the way out here just to bail in this situation. You found him in a cubby and he was pouting or something.
He was in the cubby, yeah.
And that's what's like.
In a cubby?
Yeah.
At the,
closet. It was a closet cubby. It was like a walk-in closet with a little lip-up step on it. And there was nothing in the closet, so it's basically
just
a cubby.
Sitting there pouting?
He was just sitting there pouting. And we got there, and I was like, oh, shit, Aleksey's here. I was like, oh. And then he just didn't say anything to me and fucking left. And then texted Malcolm, who was throwing up in the bathroom.
In the communal bathroom.
Yeah, instead of... Airbnb. We're in Airbnb with a shared room. It was basically an off-campus dorm.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
Except it was way smaller than a dorm.
And the toilet was so low to the ground.
Yeah, the toilet was a foot off the ground.
Oh, God, you're laying in a toilet.
Yeah, you might as well have been sitting Indian style on the toilet. That's if you cross your legs at all. And, my stomach sucks right now. Yeah, my stomach is not doing good. My brain is not doing good. That's it for me.
Damn.
Who else has a big problem this week?
Ooh, me, all pick
right.
me.
All right, Noah, what do you got
Noah's
for us?
Being a pick me
what's
right
your
now?
Biggest
pick
problem?
Girl.
Noah, what's your biggest problem of the week called?
My biggest problem of the week was dressing up as a Native American, and then every other person was saying some really interesting comments that I didn't know how to respond.
Very interesting comments.
Yeah, I don't even know. What we started, we got on the bus to head down to come see you guys near Cam's Pizza, and the bus driver was I don't even know how it initiated. Do you remember?
No.
Do you remember him speaking to us?
Yeah.
Yeah, I don't
he spoke
even know.
To you.
Fuck.
He was talking. He was asking Noah.
Oh, what kind of Indian?
Yeah, I don't remember the specifics, but it was about, like...
Nationality.
Yeah. Feather or dot. I see her wearing a crown of feathers, but feather or dot.
Yeah, no, pretty much.
He was like, are you American Indian or are you French Canadian Indian?
French Canadian, Azteca.
And then the
Mestizo.
Bus driver was like, I'm French Canadian Indian.
Yeah, I didn't know what to fucking say. I'm like, geez.
What, do you want me to tip you or something? For?
Yeah.
Thanks for the comments and the fun ride. Yeah.
Dude,
also,
sick.
The bus driver took like 5 minutes to leave the comments because he was sitting there eating a slice of pizza.
You can eat and drive.
Yeah, and I was like,
it doesn't
head,
require.
I was thinking like,
require two hands.
We're meeting people. Can yeah. like who I have told that we're on the bus, and now we're sitting here for another 5 minutes.
Yeah, we stood at the corner by the bookstore for about 10 minutes waiting.
Yeah,
when we
so
passed
fun.
You guys, he's like, "Oh, do they need to be picked up?" And we're like, "No, those are our friends." And then he's like, "Well, do you want us to pull closer?" And we're like, "No, we'll just."
Don't make this longer than it needs
to
be.
Yeah, like, just let us out, man. Stop the bus. Stop the bus.
Stop the bus.
Yeah, seriously. That's my biggest problem of the week.
Sick. Erin, what's going on with you?
Are you going to make the sound effect?
Hold on. You want the sound effect?
Yeah.
I did it.
Sadly, right, we can hear it.
My biggest problem of the week is my ceramics class. Because we're learning how to throw on the wheel. Well, actually, we learned 3 weeks ago how to throw on the wheel to make...
What, like throwing it back?
Yeah,
like
throwing it in
yeah,
reverse.
Yeah, throwing it back on the wheel. No,
yeah, yeah.
Like
but, yo, throw it in reverse, Terry. Back it up, Terry. Throw it in reverse.
To make, like, a mug. Like, you know the spinny thing and it makes the mug?
Yeah.
Yeah,
well, it doesn't
that.
Automatically make the mug, right?
No, you have to, like, you have to get it centered. And if it's not centered, then the clay wobbles all over the place. Then you have to open it. And then if that's not centered, it wobbles all over the place. And it's just every single step... that can go wrong, I have not mastered yet, and everybody else in that class has already made something, and it's been 3 weeks, and my arms, every time I do it, my arms are sore, I keep cutting my hand open on the side, and my professor's just
on
like,
wet, so
oh, well.
On wet clay?
Yeah, because there's, like, sand in the clay, because it's, like, sand and water and mud, and, like, the sand is really abrasive on the side of my hand.
So. Okay. Have you considered going to the beach to practice in your off time?
Well,
you could collect sand and water.
They're just big rocks.
Mm. Have you considered taking a sledgehammer to those and making it into
dust.
Sand?
True.
Dusting.
I'm just not thinking hard enough about it.
Yeah, modern problems, modern solutions.
Yeah.
We have technology. That technology is a stick with a big piece of metal on the end of it.
True.
Sling
true.
That bitch as hard as you can over yeah. and over again.
Slinging that bitch in reverse.
I think the modern solution reverse. That I'm going to go for is just to pay somebody else to do my projects for me.
Really? You might have to do that, yeah.
Oh.
Go on Fiverr.
That's a good idea.
Yeah, go on Fiverr and have somebody do ceramics for you and then have it shipped in 3 weeks later
oh
after the
God.
Assignment's been due 3 weeks ago.
Yeah, they're going to be like, wait, we don't have these colors. How did
no,
you
I'm
this?
Just going to make Kev do it for me.
Yeah, make big boy Kev.
Big boy Kev.
Dude,
that's
Kevin.
A man we have to get on this podcast.
Oh big God. Kevin?
You would love
you
big
would,
boy Kev.
Love Kev.
Have I met Kevin?
I don't
nope.
think so.
No. I got to get Phil. I got to get Coda. I got to get Pat and Chris. And
yeah,
I guess
Chris
now
for sure.
Kevin. Maybe Hikari, if Hikari would like to say something. He's here.
He's one of our audience members today.
I thought he was asleep.
No. Hikari's in a perpetual state of like half awake.
Yeah.
If he ever fully awakens, he'll be teleporting randomly. He can't control his power. He has to put a sleep dampener on his ninja abilities.
Yeah.
He just gets teleported. That would be crazy.
Actually, Noah, can you give the mic to Hikari for a second? I have a question for him. Please welcome Hikari, everybody.
Yes.
Thank you. Hikari, why do you have strange ninja powers?
Why do I have strange ninja powers?
Yeah.
Because I have the nine-tailed fox inside me.
Oh, all right. I guess that makes sense.
I'm actually the chosen one.
Oh, fuck. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
I'm very
I'm here
honored.
To protect the Hidden Leaf Village.
The Hidden Leaf Village, also known as SUNY Oswego College.
Yep.
All right, cool. Thank you. That answers my question. Huh?
Of course.
Hello.
Take the mic back, dude. All right. What the fuck was that? That was 9 minutes. That's crazy.
Nine
wow.
Minutes.
Time flies when we're having fun.
Oh, my God. I need like 9 Dr. Peppers injected into my veins this instant.
I have maybe some root beers up there.
That's not doctor. It doesn't.
Maybe,
it's called Dr. Pepper for a reason. It has healing properties.
Give me the DP. Maybe we can go downstairs and check the vending machine after this.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I'll do it.
Do you think I could maybe, like, break it?
No. We're going to bat. I'm going to look the other way. I never was there.
Like a doctor at a duel.
Yeah. Please don't get me kicked out of this building. I won't have anywhere else.
I'll just
to
go
live.
Without you. Like, I don't live here. I don't go to school. I'm just a guy who walked in to commit crimes, I guess.
But Sydney does know that you are with me. And
I'll ask Sydney to turn around.
She's part of the staff here, so.
She's off the clock. It's fine.
You're right.
That's true.
Yeah.
What is all this bullshit dust on my phone?
Oh, that's a powder foundation.
Oh. It does not match the complexion of my phone at all.
It matches the complexion of me. Now your phone matches me.
Damn. Why are you trying to colonize my phone?
Sorry.
You already have your own custom sticker taking up real estate space on the back of my phone.
And I appreciate that.
Do you have something to say, Malcolm? You've been handed a microphone. Well, I guess Noah Millie rocks on the floor.
Noah does the stick bug on the floor.
He kind of, he does.
Do it. Oh, there he's doing it.
Oh, there it is.
Oh, shit.
It's a visual thing.
Yeah, dude. I can't wait to cut that. That's crazy. That's brazy, bro. That's brazy.
Yo.
Malcolm, do you have a biggest problem of the week?
Yeah, sure.
Okay. All right, this sounds good.
Yeah, my biggest problem of the week is definitely shared with Cameron. It's Aleksey. This is my biggest problem of the week. Specifically, how bad of a driver he is. Like, he's so bad at driving. I can't believe he made it home alive.
We don't know that.
Yeah, we have no confirmation from him. We have not contacted him at all.
Wait, there's a fourth.
Are we doing a poll?
He's probably fucking a girl. He's probably. Yeah, he probably went to Savannah's.
Sorry. Secret third ballot. He's fucking a guy.
Holy shit.
Didn't he send somebody a snap of him on the highway?
Yeah, he did send me that.
Yeah.
What time was that?
It was an hour later.
An hour
he
after
had
he
enough
left.
Time. I don't know where on the highway he was.
I mean, that's an hour and a half.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a big enough. You can die at any time.
Yeah.
That's true.
Noah, why did you give up the mic, but then you're still saying things? Just take the mic back if you want to talk.
Yeah, no, it was just the most nauseating trip out here because he's the type of guy who never stops steering. Like, you're going in a straight line. This dude is constantly steering left, right, left, right, left, right, left, right to maintain a straight. I'm in the back seat, so I just feel the front of the car.
He has power steering,
forth,
by the
back
way.
And forth. He turns on and off his cruise control at random intervals. Sometimes it's on, sometimes, like, just completely off. Never maintains a solid speed.
Two-lane highway, anytime he goes to pass, he'll make sure he can sniff the tailpipe before he gets over.
He always rams his all the way up their ass and then gets out of the way. It's ridiculous. Every single
time. He also has no eyes. He can't see, like, at all. Like, he needs glasses legally. He's required. He has the license type where he's required to have his glasses. Yeah. And he gets pulled over all the time. I don't know how he hasn't been arrested or had his license revoked. He refuses to wear his glasses. And then he'll drive, specifically at night. He can't see anything. He also has these red tinted glasses that just completely, like, if he's driving at night, they destroy green lights. Like, they just make green lights not exist for him.
During the day.
Even during the day, they're impossible to see. Yeah. And it's like his favorite bit in the whole world. He thinks it's so funny to drive wearing the, he needs regular glasses, but he'll wear the funny red glasses. And then he'll sit at stoplights at the front and just not move, and people will honk at him. And he's like, oh, I completely forgot. I'm doing something retarded.
He's something else.
Yeah.
And I will never hang out with him without him paying for the
something.
Hangout session.
Yeah.
He just has to pay. My time.
Yeah, honestly. we should be charging him to do the videos and be his friend.
100%.
Yeah. He should be buying us everything.
Yes. Yes.
For a guy who claims to have, like, how much money in stocks did he tell you he has?
Oh, dude. He's like, listen, I don't tell anybody this, but I have $100,000 in stocks. And I take out, like, $500 a week, and then just, like, by the end of the week, it'll build back up. He's like, that's why I don't work. And like, in the moment, I was like, wow. I was like, oh, shit-faced. I was like, dude, that's so cool.
Then why isn't he paying us for the videos?
Yeah, but then I was, like, thinking about it, and I was like, dude, you piece of shit.
He lied. He just straight up lied to you. He told me $10,000.
Yeah, he's just a constant liar. He probably has no money. That $500 is probably just the allowance from his mom.
His Russian mail order.
At all.
Yeah.
I don't know why anybody in our friend group still trusts him after the countless amount of times
he... You think I trusted him coming into this?
Yeah,
I kind of
saw something.
Yeah.
That's why I want to take my own car, but alas, my tires are destroyed, so...
Yeah. Your tires are fucking super bald.
Yeah, super bald.
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 All right.
My eyes!
Handing this off to the Noah.
Welcome back, Noah. You got mobile seating arrangement now.
Your hands are warm as shit. Damn.
Mobile suit Gundam Noah.
Cold, warm hands, cold heart. Quote by Malcolm.
I bet Noah would be an insane Gundam pilot. Dude, like a so mech pilot. Life.
So sick.
Dude, you'd just be chopping dudes in half in space, going like, yo, what the fuck? Yeah, this, boom, boom, boom. This is because you're homeless.
Stop taking free handouts.
I'm killing you now. Stop crying about it. Xeon, fuck, dude. Pew, pew, pew.
Oh, man.
You'd be like Patrick playing with Squidward in the pickle. Dive bomb! The giant fist attack! You'd have so much fun killing people in a Gundam, bro.
Is Hikari sleeping?
Oh, dude. Let's keep screaming. He'll sleep through
scream,
it.
Scream, scream, scream.
Did he snore?
That's Hikari's breath.
Oh. I bet you can smell it through the audio. I bet you can smell it through your speakers or headphones right now. Oh, did we eat stuff?
We did eat some food.
We went to a diner.
Oh, yeah, we dined.
We dined.
What did I get? I got eggs, toast, hash browns.
I did not like our waitress, I gotta say. She was giving me a bit too much stank on that sauce for no fucking reason. She's super judgy.
Yeah.
Also, apple juice.
Like she,
coffee?
I understand being like a being jaded by working in the food industry, but like you work in a college town and a bunch of
Noah just fell over.
Yeah, and a bunch of like hungover kids from the college come into your diner every Friday, Saturday, Sunday morning. I guarantee.
Yeah.
Why are you being such a bitch?
Yeah,
because you were like Noah ordered, and then Erin, you ordered.
Yeah, and I ordered. I was really hungry, and I really wanted carbs, so I ordered a piece of toast.
Well, you got one piece of white toast.
One piece of white toast.
And she before you said mozzarella sticks, she immediately said, toast. Where are we going with this?
Yeah, I was like, I'm hungry. Food.
I'm hungry.
So I got the toast.
We're going to my belly in a minute, hopefully.
I got mozzarella sticks, and then I got a BLT.
Okay, that's not absurd.
No, it's not. It's just food.
But she's super juggy.
It was literally 2:33 p.m.
Yeah.
It was lunchtime. It's lunchtime food.
And I order, and she's like, are you going to do the same thing as her? Like in the mocking tone. What?
As if the thing that I ordered
was like absurd.
Weird,
yeah. As if you ordered like the pretty patty from SpongeBob.
Yeah, or like spaghetti and meatballs and a fruit platter mixed together.
Yeah, no, it's not absurd. I said, fuck it, yeah, give me white toast and some bacon, because I don't think I can eat very much right now, and I couldn't.
White toast.
I don't know. And then, I don't know, the food was fine. It was bacon and toast and apple juice and coffee. And
you ordered the apple juice and the coffee, she was like, what the fuck?
Dude, come on. Shut up. Bitch, I work in food and bar, too. Yeah. Shut up.
Yeah, you're not funny, old lady.
She's one of my big... Yeah, dude, old ladies who work at diners are not funny. That's one of my big... That's... You know what? Fuck it. Biggest problem of today.
Biggest problem of today,
the diner lady, not the fact that you got stranded in Oswego.
Well, we went over that already.
I know.
That was even
bigger.
That was technically my biggest problem of last night, because it happened at 3 in the morning.
Well, it's still 2.
Technically, the day... I know that, like, in terms of how the 24-hour clock works, but the day doesn't start until the sun comes up.
Let's
be real. Or when you wake up.
Or when you wake, sleep. Yeah.
That's valid.
But naps don't count.
Yeah, nap don't count.
Nap don't count.
If you sleep, if you sleep one sun up, it don't count.
Yeah.
Oh my god.
Yeah, we did it.
Yeah, dude, we did it. We did something.
We're here. So what are our? We're trying to figure out some plans for. I guess.
Yeah.
So what's today's Saturday?
Today is Saturday.
Right? Dude, today's Saturday.
Crazy.
We have to find you guys sleeping arrangements.
Yeah.
I was thinking, just go into the commons and beg. Just beg.
Just beg.
Please. I don't know. Please, we got stranded.
Yeah, Coda and Phil's couch or Chris's place or I don't know.
Realistically, honestly, there's plenty of sofas and like the thing, like in this building. Yeah. The thing is that each individual floor. So if really, if you wanted to, you could just go to the top floor and crash up there. Nobody would bother you.
Yeah, literally nobody would bother
like,
you.
Like no,
up there.
And you get like the coolest view because you get to see over the whole campus.
Yeah, you I've, get to like, see the really lake and everything. Bad.
I've slept in the fucking in, the in common the, rooms of.
And if you have like a laptop, I don't know if any of you guys brought anything. You could just suck it up to the TV.
Yeah, I have a laptop. Yeah,
just hang out.
I'm gonna go crazy playing Fire Emblem all night. Maybe we could do that actually.
You have Fire Emblem with you?
I have my laptop. Yeah.
Oh, that's sick. Do you have your
fight stick?
Fight stick.
Yeah,
that's great.
You
want
to play some games, dude?
Gaming.
Let's Yo, do you want a top 10 gaming of all time?
If we got nothing to do, that's what we'll... And honestly... Yeah,
Yo,
we'll,
I present top 10, Watch Mojo's top 10 gaming of
that
all
means,
time.
Dude, that means you don't have to... The thing, too, is that if you stayed at the commons, you would have to... If you needed to use the restroom or something, you have to go through somebody's room. And so it's like...
That's true.
Yeah, I'll hold it. Like, ah. I'll hold it.
Yeah, I'll hold it.
Or I'll sleep with them. Fuck it.
Phil,
I'll just put all my points into Hikari, charisma today.
I need to use your restroom.
Intelligence and charisma. I'll put all.
Yeah,
I'll,
I think your strength points are already a little bit down today too.
I've slept in it.
Yeah, I'm definitely encumbered for
yeah,
sure.
Me too.
Yeah, honestly, right. Realistically, I feel like you guys will probably end up here.
Whatever. I don't care.
Which is literally no issue. We'll just figure it out.
Yeah.
That's enough for me. Anything else you guys want to say?
Did you just fart.
You had cabbage?
Cabbage these nuts across
That made no fucking sense,
man. Cabbage these nuts across your face.
Cabbage these nuts across your face. No one shut the fuck up.
That's me as a Gundam pilot. Cabbage these nuts, boy. Slice, slice.
How about Zeon missile these nuts?
Yeah, like, dude, I'd be the best at voicing.
Suck on my missile punch.
Bro, if they like, if somebody came up and said, "Yo, can you just be yourself and like be a character at the same time?" That I'm already a character, so
yes,
I'm player number one, bro.
Yeah, we could write a character.
You are a
plot
character.
Armor.
Yeah. Problem is, when you play D&D, you can't have too many of that. Aleksey already does that. He already plays the murder hobo, but your personality already is murder hobo, and you can't have two in one. It just doesn't work like that.
When we went to go stop at the Dunkin' near our house and hang out with the homeless guy that was playing the guitar while sharing cigarettes.
I never want to do that again.
I fucking was that like, guy's oh, turn here, turn here.
No, that kind of behavior is going to get you killed very soon, I promise. Murdered.
Can I say one thing?
Yeah, what do you want to say?
Just that whole little spiel reminded me of the man we saw outside of the Sting last night.
Oh, the dancing homeless man?
Yeah.
Homeless.
And
I loved
just
that.
Thought that should be mentioned.
That was a highlight of
that
my night.
In addition to all that happened last night, there was also a dancing homeless man outside of a bar.
Hmm.
Our bar experience was subpar, I feel like, to an extent. But like,
it was pretty mad.
But like, being with you guys was more than enough.
Oh, yeah. It was so much fun.
So
yeah.
Like, that
it
was great. But like, when I say bar experience, well, I'm talking about when we go to the club.
And it's so crowded it's, that
you
can't move. You
can't
move.
Fucking use the stairs, bro.
Yeah.
Like, there's no
Imagine
egress.
If I wore my Fall Guys inflatable 8-foot costume.
You wouldn't
fit.
No.
Actually, you would have had like your own little bubble of space, though.
Yeah.
Yeah. Every black guy I saw last night who didn't have a costume, who was with somebody else, I was like, oh my god, it's Spider-Man and nigga. And a lot of them did not like it. What are you dressed as, nigga? I did drop the Adolf Hitler one on a black guy. He did not like it at all either.
What did that one guy outside of the bar say about Noah's costume?
Oh my god, I don't even know.
It was something about, track. Like, that's legit or something like that.
That was legit.
Yeah,
what he said. It was that little kid with the scooter.
Much, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. I remember when we went to the party, that dude's house party, and, fuck.
That house party was fucking lame. That was my second biggest problem of last night.
I'm sorry.
No, don't be sorry. Nothing is your friend.
Yeah. I didn't realize that it was BYOB. She didn't tell me. She was just like, I'm having a party. Bring people. Yeah, I know, because she was, all week, she was like, guys, I think there's going to be too many people at the house. She's like, and we're, like, counting, and I think at one point, the tally was up to, like, 80 people.
Damn.
Like, RSVP'd?
Yeah.
Damn, for a house that big? That's
yeah.
too much.
Yeah.
And there was not a lot of backyard space to arrange that.
No, I don't even know. I didn't even explore the house, because I felt, like unwanted there, so I was like, shit.
It was such a weird
Yeah, I was trying to like be like, hi, how you doing? Like, yeah.
Maybe I'm a slightly
Maybe Malcolm's
retarded,
fucking retarded.
But I just, like, every single person there just seemed too... Yeah, stink eye. I felt, like, out of place. And, like, it makes sense, because, like...
They're all, like...
I am, but...
They're all, like, frat people.
They're, like, normal people. Like, normie type.
They're pretty NPC.
NPC.
And I didn't... I guess I didn't realize that it wasn't, like, the vibes were going to be weird.
Yeah.
You know?
Because I was just like, wow, this is, like, too...
Because it's, like... I'm thinking about, like, how you guys are, and you guys will get along with everybody. Mm-hmm. So in my mind, I'm thinking, oh, it's going to be fine. Everybody gets along with everybody. It'll be fine. And then it was just not.
I feel like there was just too many cliques. I think
that's what it was.
It was just cliques,
too.
And it was like nobody knew us. So it was like, all right.
That's valid.
Hey, we're here.
We crashed their party low key. Yeah, really? we high key crashed the party.
Like, we were
hey,
invited.
We're here. And they're like, okay, who are you? Here.
What are you dressed as? Here?
Yeah.
You dressed as my house?
Literally. And also, I don't think any of us were fucked up enough to make it enjoyable. Like, if we were all, like, if it was end of the night when we were there, different story.
Yeah.
Totally.
Yeah. If that's where we ended up, yeah, probably.
Yeah. Yeah. Completely.
Thanks. It'd be a great reality if we had our own house up here. We just had our own house, but that's not how that works.
I feel like every 3 months, one of us just says, dude, wouldn't it be great if we just had our own house? That's like just one of our recurring talking points.
Your own house. I need to be like that.
That's not a house. That's an apartment complex.
We need a house. A home.
Move in next week to a different apartment in our own building. So
that's basically
like moving to the third floor.
Well, the third floor.
It's slightly smaller, but it's got 5 big ass windows, and it's just a way cooler design overall. Like it's just, and it's got like 9 foot tall ceiling, or no, not 9 foot, it's like 11 foot tall ceilings.
Damn.
They're stupid tall. Like I
Noah
can't,
will never hit his head, and Cam.
It's perfect.
They'll never hit their heads ever. Literally.
I don't hit my head on the ceiling as it is.
No.
Well, it sucks because the current apartment we have, it's a basement apartment, so you can just like practically reach up and change light bulbs.
Yeah.
But like, because like I have a bunch of those like Google like smart light bulbs, so I can like, you know, turn them on, whatever. Like, oh, you know, hey Google, turn on all the lights, and they all turn on. I can't do that now. What I am gonna do is lamps. Use a bunch more lamps.
Yeah,
that's the move.
You can get.
How about candelabras? Maybe
you
should go candelabra.
Changing lamps too.
That's actually
just a bunch of Ebenezer Scrooge and fucking sleeping gowns.
That's the way to do it, honestly.
Yeah, RGB strip lights, just lining the place.
Hell yeah!
All right, back to Noah.
Alright.
Back to me.
Anything else we gotta say before we call it? That's good enough for me.
Yeah. Killing it.
Cool.
Mudded.
I'll try to do like 2 or 3 more of these.
Hopefully
today.
Hopefully get Chris and Phil in the cover.
Yeah.
Maybe Hikari if he wakes up.
Off. That's Mischief Mini number something.
Bye bye.
Bye. Okay.